Now let us move our focus and conclude with the system of government which is existing according to the constitution. Let us see here. System of the government. The system of the government, as the constitution framers have ensured, we would not like to have any monarchic type of government or any other form of government which is not accountable to the people. They have prescribed for the parliamentary type of government. Wherein all, the parliament stands supreme. All the members will be elected by the people directly. Prime Minister will be heading the government of the ruling party and President will head the government. And all are answerable and accountable in the parliament. So this provides the supremacy of the parliament, where the debates will be going on in the parliament and discussed in the parliament. Before a bill gets drafted, it should be passed in the parliament, then only it can be approved. So it provides the parliamentary that supremacy there. And moving on to the federal setup of the government. In parliament, we have the Prime Minister, leader of the party, ruling party in the parliament, and we have the President, the head of the nation. Then moving on, we have the federal setup. The federal structure of India has been adopted from the Canadian structure. India has a strong central government, but at the same time, India has the autonomy of providing the union state governments also. We have a union government and we have the state governments. The union government is also known as central government. The state governments are known with the respective state governments. And the power were being divided between the central governments and the state governments under the list of provisions called state list, central list, and the concurrent list. So the union government or the central government makes laws on the subjects like army, then on the railway, the other etc. Then the state governments have rights to make laws on the police, road transport, all these things. Like that we have a clear cut specification of division of the subjects which ensures the authority and the freedom for the state governments as well as for the union government. And moving on to the two major houses of the parliament. The Lok Sabha and the Raj Sabha. All the members of Lok Sabha are elected by the people directly. But to Raj Sabha, the members elected to the state assemblies will in turn elect the members of the Raj Sabha. Which makes to ensure that the making of the bills in the parliament will have the say of the state governments. So in this way, the parliament provides equal opportunity for the states as well as for the people's representatives. And moving on, we also have some independent bodies to look after the various activities of the government. Let us see them. One is judiciary. Then we have election commission. The judiciary provides for us looking after the law of the court without any binding on it. It has independent state and structure for us. And moving on to the election commission. Election commission makes sure that it provides free and fair manner of conducting the elections without binding itself to any kind of pressures from the union government or the state government or from the any external bodies. Then we also have the Comptroller and the Auditor General. The Comptroller and the Auditor General revises and checks the entire expenditure, the money spent, everything in detail, and provides for us the outsheet to the Parliament. In this way, the Constitution has provided a perfect structure of these institutions. Then how does they work? What are the divisions of the powers? What are the fundamental rights of the citizens? What are the directive principles of the state policies? What are the goals that has to be attained by the states in order to achieve equality in these regions? All these were enshrined in the constitution and have been implemented successfully from the past 60 years. And the makers of the constitution has also had a feeling that we should ensure that this constitution is a living document and leads or meets the expectations of the people. And it has to be revised as per the changing rules or the situations or the growing needs of the people. So, it has also prescribed a format and a procedure to go for the amendments. And till now, till date of 2011, Indian Constitution has been amended several times to making it a live document. It has been in record that till now, 97 times the Indian Constitution has been revised and amended. So now we have seen in this lesson the entire structure of from the framing of the constitution, then moving on, what are the basic ideologies which were guided for the framing of the constitution. Then we have the other aspects like how was the objective resolution passed, what is the framework given for the constituent assembly, how was the constituent assembly elected. Then moving on, how we got split after India and Pakistan were divided. We got separate constituent assemblies. Then how many days the constituent assembly worked? For 114 days. Then who was the main person who drafted the entire constitution? The drafting committee chairman. Then we have viewed the views of Mahatma Gandhiji, B.R. Ambedkar and Jawaharlal Nehru. Mahatma Gandhiji stressing on for having a respect for a poor and rich in an equal manner, where poor people also can contribute in the equal say as it is in the rich in the nation of India. Then moving on to Ambedkar, his anxiety on the inequality concept, which has to be eliminated very soon. And then Jawaharlal Nehru wishes that no eye in India will shed a tear until and unless this kind of situation occurs, we can't stop working. All these have provided the life of the constitution, a living and a true spirit of the Indians, where Indians have been suffering from the past 200 years. We also have analyzed what is the preamble state for us. Preamble is a short statement of the entire constitution to provide a basic insight for us about the constitution. We the people of India solemnly resolve to constitute India to be a sovereign, secular, democratic republic and to ensure to all its citizens equality. Then we have justice. Then we have liberty. Then we have fraternity. So these all are the basic structures which we have analyzed in this lesson. Hope you all have got clear idea of all these things.